to the W. I'm TJ Merli.
And I'm Julie Lomurno.
In this month's episode, we focus on behind the scenes at Westlake. These episodes offer a sneak peek into what goes on in certain areas of our school life. We are trying to increase awareness, create excitement, and get some audience feedback. We took a quick look in to find out what some classes are really like.
We took a sneak peek into our security team, taking a look behind the curtain to find how they do their job. How about athletics? Why play a sport? Take a look and find out what athletes are doing outside their game time. How about what goes on into putting an amazing concert? Join us in this month's episode to find out more about life at Westlake.
Like using a toothbrush, physics is something that we use every day. But how? Here at Westlake, physics is a science that can explain how we use physics every day, most times without even knowing it.
Physics is all around us and we can't avoid it. Want to take a class to see how physics works and see how the world really moves? Hi, I'm Julie Lomurno with the W. Physics is one of the many science courses offered here at Westlake. Utilizing a problem-solving approach, students will be taught the skills and techniques used by scientists and technicians. Within this segment, I interview Westlake's physics teachers along with Westlake senior and physics student Kathleen Bennett.
Hello, I'm Mrs. Newell. I teach physics and AP physics at Westlake High School.
Hi, my name is Mr. Clark. I teach physics and engineering here at Westlake.
What is physics?
The study of what we see in our world and our universe and how we can explain it. What always stuck with me was what my high school physics teacher said, was that it was a way to predict the future.
How is physics connected to the real world?
One of the great things about physics is science that is really readily connected to the real world. But you can see it so well in physics. If you watch any sports, the trajectory of a basketball, a baseball, or anything is that parabolic trajectory that we see in classic physics.
What topics of physics do students learn throughout the year?
Speed, acceleration.
Momentum, which is part of our interaction. Forces.
Things moving due to gravity.
Electricity.
What experiments are done in physics?
Right now, some of the experiments we're doing involve setting up circuits. I think because students really enjoy circuits because it's so hands-on, so students really like that as well.
Calculating distances, predicting where things are going to land. My favorite lab is a lab that we do where students calculate the various measurements to predict where a marble will land and then see it in real time hit or miss a target that they place.
Hi, my name is Kathleen Bennett, and I'm a senior at Westlake.
What would you tell a new student or an underclassman about physics?
I would tell them it's a little difficult. Don't get discouraged and just keep working hard.
What was your favorite experiment done in physics?
It was where we rubbed like fur onto, I think it was like a ruler or something, and to see like the static and electricity and stuff like that, and like how it moved.
Would you recommend this class to underclassmen?
If you're going in for engineering or something, yeah, definitely. If you want to challenge yourself, yeah, definitely take it.
Hopefully this segment accelerates your excitement and you can take a shot at physics. See for yourself how physics relates to the world. Once you make the connection, you can't stop the circuit. Me being a physics student this year, one of the highlights of the class for me is all the experiments. In this class, there are many moments that make you question how things really work. This has been Julie Lomurno with the W. Hope to see you in physics. Back to you at the studio.
Students and faculty spend all year preparing for the concert. A lot of work goes on behind the scenes to make this event special for musicians, teachers, and parents. Take a peek as junior reporter Ryan Dierssen goes behind the scenes.
They say April showers bring May flowers. Or do they bring fine music from Westlake's band and chorus? Join me today as I interview Mr. Capano, our band teacher, Ms. Denler, our chorus teacher, and some students involved in the music program here at Westlake, finding out how they feel about the upcoming concert.
Our complete band is between 80 and 90 students, but we meet half of the kids ACE and the other half VDF. So we never really play together as a unit. Mm-hmm. So when around concert time, like now, we all get together and we put the whole band together. And it's a really nice experience when you first hear it and for the students to hear it for the first time. The exciting part of performance is that once a song starts, you have to go through. One of the things that I enjoy the most is to see the students really focused, and they are super focused because they want to contribute to it, to a good performance. I've been here over 30 years, so I know these procedures, you know, year after year, and this is particularly exciting because this concert, because it's the first time that we were able to do this since December of 2019. So we're really looking forward to this.
Folks, I'm here with Junior Thomas Reynolds and Junior Ryan Smith. How do you feel about this concert coming up at the end of the week?
I think we're looking pretty good. You know, we got some strong players on this team. I think so. You know, we've had to social distance. Last concert, we only got to play with, 30 kids per concert. So it's definitely going to be different this year.
I agree with everything Ryan said. It's really good to play with a full band, a lot more sound. Everyone gets to play. It's going to be a lot better.
I'm very excited for the concert. This is not my first concert because we did a winter concert in the beginning of the year, but it is my first concert with the band because last concert for the winter concert, it was just a chorus concert and just a band concert for COVID purposes. But this year, this semester, we get to do both. So that's exciting. We'll have a bigger audience and no masks this time, so I'm very excited for this one. I am a little bit nervous, but if I could take on Mamma Mia and do all of the Mamma Mia things, then I think I can do a concert. And that's what I keep telling myself to make the nerves go away, is if I could do Mamma Mia, I could do anything.
Wow, what a great amount of work that goes into this concert. I hope to see you guys there on Thursday. Back to you at the Anchor Desk.
Westlake Baseball is making a deep playoff run this year. Follow TJ Merli as he takes us behind the scenes of what it takes to make such a great team.
Hi, I'm TJ Merli, and Westlake's one win away from making the section championship in baseball for the first time since 2019. Today, I'm going to be showing you some of our best highlights, some of the biggest contributors, and why you should come out and watch the games. The games are very exciting, very fun, and I hope to see you all there. Being led by senior pitcher JJ Jaquette, who transferred back from Iona, and big help from Robbie Silberti, who also transferred back, along with the supporting players who have been here, such as Tommy Giacone and Anthony Archiello. And you know what? This team's one of the best teams Westlake's had, and we're one win away, and we hope to see you all there. Let's go.
I'm about to interview the junior pitcher and third baseman who came back from Kennedy, Robbie Silberti. Here we have a picture of Robbie standing in front of a North Salem senior tribute, name and cups, showing them they just lost. Hi, I'm here with junior Robbie Silberti. Robbie just transferred back after going to Kennedy for 2 years. Robbie, what are some of the reasons you came back?
I was getting bored at Kennedy, you know, everything with COVID. I was just fed up with it, and I just wanted to come back to Westlake with my friends and just have a good season.
He just wanted to come home. Robbie also plays baseball. He's one of our best pitchers. Robbie, how are you feeling about the team this year?
We're really good. We're a good group of guys. We have a lot of talent. We just got to work hard and have a good postseason, and we'll win the section.
Playoffs are coming up. We expect you to be there. Thank you.
Thank you, too.
On the face of my city, co-signed by Diddy, hard liquor, I'm hotel, some bitty, gotta do my bidding, you change, no kidding,
yeah, baby,
runway,
I'm fitting,
the way we ain't winning, back home for a week, ain't no way we ain't sinning, if she can't stay with me, ain't no way she ain't pretty, got the 808 hitting, y'all some internet thugs, won't come face to face with me, y'all would hate to play with me, tummy tuck it one time, she'll pay to stay skinny, I done been on that road, I done ate some great Denny's, yeah. And some Cracker Barrel, little brother with me selling Jack of Pearls. She a rich girl, she done had Camaros. Cheap a two, keep a Willie Caballero. White boy with a little habanero. I just hit 100, I was at a zero. I'm a big boss.
Yeah, yeah, get up, get up, get up, get up.
On the face of the to an angel. I start demolishing when I'm angry, but don't be following me that day. Dealing the problem, my little is bang. I ran my projects before I was famous. Straight from the bottom, you know I ain't changed. Everything cash, you know how I play. Like I love her, she know I ain't stand. Pass it a dog, you know how I play. Act like I'm dumb, but you know I ain't crazy. Big baby. On the face of my city, co-signed by Diddy. Hard liquor, I'm hotel, some bitty. Got it doing my bidding. You change, no kidding. Wasn't always this pretty.
Brand new whip, just hopped in. I got options. I can pass that like Stockton. just joshing. We spend this holiday locked in. My body got rid of them toxins. Explosive toxins. I can put a ball in the end zone. Put a ball in the end zone. Show me the intro, Jesse. Give me that tempo.
Atta boy!
Amigos got that free smoke on the West Coast. Yeah, I'm talking about pre-rolls. Dark hair.
Boy!
Not
a boy.
Certified freak, hang around dust, and she learning my lingo. Back then, wasn't worried about me, though. In the gym, trying to work on my free throw.
Yes!
Spending money at the
club. Get over,
like
get over! Alright.
Yes,
dig.
She don't put this on the ground. Little boy trying to get on the ground. Direction, even some homies wearing expressions. I be discouraged from sharing my blessings. We used to share a connection. Now it just feels like it's wearing and stretching. I'm getting rich, taking advice from people that never could stand reflections.
Yeah!
I'm at the club with the basketball team. Me and the Cardinals are sharing a session.
In a tie game in the top of the seventh, the runners on first and third, Anthony Archiello hits a high and deep fly ball that goes foul, and the right fielder chooses to drop it instead of letting the runner at third tag up and let Arch's at bat keep going. Arch walks over and tells the coach that was a mistake. And yet what he does after is huge.
Yeah, baby! Yes! What a boy, Tim! What a boy, baby! Yes, baby! Attaboy!
Thank you for watching. I'm TJ Merli, and I hope you enjoyed all those clips that you saw. And I hope to see you at Westlake's playoff games as we continue to make this historic run. Back to you at the Anchor Desk. Studio art is one of many art classes offered at Westlake. Although most ninth graders take this class, it's open to anyone. Take a look into one of the many fun projects Ms. Morris does with her studio art class, and hear some feedback from students on why to take the class.
Hi, I'm Lena Palushaj.
And I'm Elise Stuetz.
And today we're going behind the scenes of Ms. Morris's studio art class. What is your project?
My project's based off like a Polaroid camera, and it like takes the picture and like goes into like depth about like the memory. It's like scenery wise, like summer.
So it's about basically this old man. He gets on a hot air balloon, and it just shows him like floating up and where he's going in the end.
We're doing an under the water scene with a shark, a fish, and a narwhal. The shark just chases the fish through like the ocean.
My stop motion is about a tree growing, and then the apple's growing on the tree, and then an apple falls, and then a caterpillar eats it.
It's a cardboard stop motion of, I don't know, like a cardboard character, like dunking a basketball.
I'm doing a video of me going to the library and then me like swiping away at the books, and the book just moves. I have to take a picture every second. It's really annoying, but I like it.
What's your favorite project that you work on in this class?
This is actually one of my favorite projects. In addition to teaching studio art, I also teach photo, which I had you in. And this is kind of a really nice blend between media arts and studio arts, because students are using photography to create the films.
What's your favorite part about the class?
My favorite part is probably the great teacher, Ms. Morris.
Probably the projects. They're fun.
My favorite part is the stop motion unit.
Projects that we do.
I like how everything's like really creative and original and not like anything we've done before.
Why do you think people should take this class next year?
Because many of the fun projects we do, for example, my favorite was a sculpture unit. You can learn a lot about art and stuff. So that's interesting.
You get to do a lot of fun, different projects, and it's just such a fun class to take.
Because it's fun and you learn a lot.
Because it's a lot of hands-on stuff, and if you like that, the class is for you.
It's fun working together. We do a lot of group projects.
I like all like the hands-on interactive projects that we do.
Because of the teacher, Ms. Morris is amazing. She's the best teacher.
This has been Lena Palushaj.
And Elise Stuetz. Make sure you put Studio Art on your schedule next year.
This has been Lena Palushaj.
And Elise Stuetz. Make sure you put Studio Art on your schedule next year.
You see us here on screen, but have you ever wondered how we get here? Do you wonder what process that goes into filming our episodes for you guys? Well, strap up as Danny Alvarez shows us behind the scenes of broadcasting.
Welcome back to the W. My name is Danny Alvarez, and I'm here to give you behind the scenes of broadcasting. There's a lot that goes behind the scenes of broadcasting, such as the equipment needed to film, such as cameras, microphones, and teleprompters. Before you start any film, you must write a script that directs the film. There's a lot that can go into these films. For starters, a script. Coming up with a script is not easy, as it can take a lot of discussing. After we come up with the script, we then begin to film. After filming, we then import all of the footage to Final Cut Pro. After importing the footage, we then begin to edit the footage. We edit the footage to our liking to bring you a perfect segment. After we complete the script, filming, and editing, we all together as a class put our footage together and merge it into an episode for the month. After someone edits all of our footage together, we have two people present the entire episode at the anchor desk. After your first year in broadcasting, how do you feel like you improved?
I feel like I've gotten better at editing. I think I did better at speaking.
Do you think broadcasting is a useful skill?
I do think broadcasting is a useful skill because you learn how to edit and everything. So you can make videos on your free time, make funny stuff.
Why do you think people should take broadcasting?
I think people should take broadcasting because honestly, it's like definitely the best class ever. Like you definitely like not only learn things on the computer, but like learn more about yourself too. Like I definitely found myself so more outgoing in this class. Also, it's so much fun because like, you get to meet new people, make new friends, and you get to know about people in your school.
So I just provided you multiple reasons why you should take broadcasting and a understanding of what goes behind the film. This has been Danny Alvarez, back to you at the anchor desk.
I'm sure you've noticed some of our new security officers around Westlake.
Oh yeah, like Officer K.
Here's Rocco and Dean on the new guards here at Westlake.
Hello and welcome to the W. I'm Dean Williams.
And I'm Rocco Dominguez. The security detail here at Westlake is nothing short of spectacular.
Today, we're going to take you behind the scenes and find out what makes it so darn effective.
With criminal activities such as vandalism and horseplay on the rise here at Westlake, administration decided to step things up.
With the recent hiring of the famous Officer K, as well as the appointment of Charles Conway, among others, to bathroom monitorization, Westlake students have never felt safer.
Recently, students at Westlake have reached an all-time high when it comes to shenanigans. From throwing wet toilet paper on the bathroom walls to the numerous school fights, Westlake is proceeding down a downward spiral.
Luckily enough, Officer K is here to save the day.
Now on the day I was born, the nurses all gathered round, and they gazed in wide wonder at the joy they had found. The head nurse spoke up, said, leave this one alone. She could tell right away that I was bad to the bone.
All right, I'm here with Officer K. Officer K, what does being a security guard here at Westlake entail?
Ooh, a lot of responsibilities. I got 9th, 10th, 11th, 12th graders. It's rough, but I'm dealing with it.
Officer K, have you done security work in the past at any other schools?
Yes, I have. I also did. I'm a retired correction officer.
Really?
Yeah.
How was that?
Oh, it's totally different from being here.
Yeah, are the Westlake students worse here? Or?
Oh, no, definitely not.
Officer K, who is your favorite student here at Westlake?
JP.
Why is that?
I had many encounters with that individual.
Many run-ins with JP?
Oh, yeah, JP and his crew.
JP and the crew. Yeah. Officer K, while you're occupied in the cafeteria, who's dealing with the bathroom shenanigans?
Oh, Charlie, he's a hall monitor.
Officer K, thanks for coming out. I appreciate it.
No problem. Anytime.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
As Officer K stated, she's not the only titan here at Westlake. Mr. Conway, who has been at Westlake before, is responsible for patrolling the school bathrooms.
Known as the guardian to many Westlake students, Mr. Conway strikes fear into the hearts of Westlake's outlaws.
We asked some students and staff what they think of the recent security changes here at Westlake. Here's what we got.
Joey, who's your favorite security guard in the building?
It would have to be Security Guard K, because she is very safe about what our children do.
Strong choice, thank you.
So who's your favorite security guard at Westlake?
Lieutenant K.
Mrs. Frawley, have you noticed any behavioral changes around the building since Officer K's arrival?
Her presence, she shows up, she does what she needs to do, everyone scatters. Bam.
Definitely.
Gone.
Thank you. Have you noticed any behavioral changes since the arrival of Officer K?
You know, I think that K was a very good addition to the school, and I think that she, like, really enforces the rules. I think she's a good addition to the school.
Amen.
Do you boys believe that the recent security changes here are necessary?
To be fair, I feel a lot safer now that we have Lieutenant K in the building. She also does a great job at directing the traffic, you know. She's really motivational, too.
Thanks, boys. Anytime.
Of course.
How you doing, ladies and gentlemen? We are here with Mr. Iovanni. So, Io, as a lunch monitor and someone in the industry, what are your thoughts on Officer K?
I think Officer K is very good at her job. She's very diligent, and she tends to be very on top of you children.
Definitely.
She stretches her vocal cords.
Absolutely.
And then everything goes back to being very copacetic.
Well, thank you, Io.
You're welcome.
As you can see, the security changes have certainly changed Westlake for the better.
With these new additions, students can frolic around the halls without any worry.
Being safe in school is very important, perhaps the most important thing, as safety comes first.
Administration's emphasis on this is seen through their recent actions, hiring these two sultans of security. Thanks for watching and stay safe out there. This has been The W. Back to you. But I was bad to the bone. Bad to the bone. Bad to the bone. Bad. Bad.
Thank you for joining us this month.
Don't forget to tune in one more time as our final report is about investigations to find out who murdered Ms. Hoffman.
This has been TJ Merli
and Julie Lomurno.